Yates par rapport à Edgar Allan Poe et que ça n'avait pas vraiment rapport pour l'instant, mais peut-être qu'il songerait à un certain point. Dave, I got a question for you. As a father myself, I got two kids. I got to ask you this. You're expecting very soon. Is that going to change your perspective? Because I feel you got a lot of concern about world peace, perhaps environment and stuff like that. Do you think it's going to help you focus your concern in a different way?
I certainly think that that it makes it seem more urgent, you know, when I'm gone, there'll be echoes. You know, my children will be here, and hopefully we don't leave behind a wasteland. So it does make it a little more urgent that you want to make sure that we leave behind a healthy planet where living comfortably is feasible.
What about Boyd? You already have kids. How do you foresee the future for them?
I have two kids, man. I just want them to. My kids, I just want them to grow up, you know, with a lot of love, which I give them all the time, and my wife gives them all the time. And, you know, I want them to have a world that's better than, you know, what I grew up in. You know, especially in America, there's a lot of issues, you know, involving race and so forth that I have a feeling are getting better, you know, and I think that my kids are, you know, sort of beginning to benefit from, you know, some of the better changes in that direction, but I hope they continue to get better. And I mean, you all seem to be doing a pretty good job of it up here in Canada, you know. And
you're welcome to come back anytime.
J'ai demandé à Dave qu'est-ce qu'il pensait, étant donné qu'il s'apprête à être papa. Il y a déjà des papas dans le groupe aussi. Je lui demandais si ça l'aiderait peut-être, étant donné qu'il va être papa bientôt, à focusser carrément ses concernations ou ses concerns ou ses sensibilisations face à l'environnement, face à l'énergie. Si ça va l'aider tout simplement à rapprocher sa sensibilisation ou sa sensibilité face à ces événements-là qui se passent un petit peu partout sur la Terre. Sa plus importante demande ou sa plus importante, son plus grand souhait, c'est que ses enfants aient une planète saine pour grandir. C'est la même chose pour tous les papas, j'ai l'impression, dans le groupe et moi-même également, et tous les papas partout, c'est que la planète soit quand même encore assez propre pour que nos enfants puissent grandir et s'épanouir pleinement. On fait une pause, on revient dans quelques instants avec l'émission L'artiste du bois Music Lust, Dave Matthews Band!
Pour rejoindre Dave Matthews Band live à Music Plus, faites-le 514-790+, le 514-790-7587 pour Montréal, ou le 1...
Is it hot enough for you?
It's warm in here.
It's insane. It's like a sauna.
It's warm in here. And in 10 years, we're gonna be saying, it's hot and 172 degrees outside. Hopefully not.
Last night at the show, you played a couple of songs that were on the famous Lily White Sessions, the famous album that ended up on Napster. I'm assuming that, you know, now that it's been said and done, I guess things are more or less okay with it?
Well,
you're still playing the songs.
Yeah, well, we love the songs because they were great songs, and they're still great songs, and they mean the world to us, and all of us agree that they're some of the best songs we've ever done. The reason we left the studio and tried something different was because there was a real weight, a real foot in the mud struggle on the first album, and we didn't get it to a point where we wanted it. And it was like the first month we were recording was like some of the best things we ever done. The second month was like, ugh. And by the fifth month, we were like, man, we gotta get out of here. This is hot. It's summertime. It was wintertime. So it was really, it was a thing for ourselves, and we loved the work we did. I know in some ways from the fans that Glenn's gotten a bad rap, but I tell you, Mr. Ballard, but I tell you that he's one of the dearest men, one of the smartest men in the world, and all he wanted to do with us was make a great record, and I think we did. And I just want to tell everyone that I think he's a great man, and the Lil White Sessions, we haven't forgot them. We just probably want to, we're playing them better than we ever have. We just probably want to go back in and do them again, you know?
Les vrais fans de Dave Matthews Band connaissent tous probablement l'album culte Lily White Sessions. C'était l'album que le Dave Matthews Band travaillait sur lequel, au moment de la sortie de l'album, ils ont décidé de virer de bord complètement puis d'aller enregistrer un autre album différent avec Glenn Ballard, l'album Everyday qu'on connaît tous. Mais cet album-là, Lily White Sessions, s'est retrouvé sur Internet. Et il y a beaucoup de choses qui ont été dites. Et justement, lors du spectacle d'hier soir au Centre Molson, le groupe a interprété quelques chansons de cet album-là et vont interpréter une chanson également plus tard ce soir. Et Dave mentionnait que le fait d'avoir travaillé avec Glenn Ballard, Glenn a eu vraiment une mauvaise réputation, ou encore on a été un peu méchant à l'égard de Glenn pour avoir changé le son du groupe, pour avoir changé un peu le matériel en quelque sorte. Mais Dave disait que le matériel qu'ils ont fait pour The Lead White Sessions sont probablement les meilleures chansons qu'ils ont fait, mais au moment de les lancer, c'était pas vraiment ce que le groupe avait envie de faire. Et le fait d'avoir travaillé avec Glenn leur a permis justement d'apprendre de nouvelles choses. Camelia now is with the public.
Hey.
We now have a question from a fan who wants to ask you guys something.
Hi.
Cindy.
Hi. I was at the show yesterday. It was awesome. You guys totally rocked. And I want to know if you have any side projects that you do to take your mind off the studio and touring other than ATO Records that I know that you started not long ago.
What are we doing? You're always doing stuff.
Yeah. musically, I think we all try to do different stuff just to keep it fresh and keep it honest and keep a balance of some sort. And there are other projects outside of the music thing that we do all the time. So one of my probably just as equal as playing music is, for me, is flying. So every chance I get, I go up in an airplane and just, you know, do a cruise, you know?
You're going to take me up there sometime.
Yeah, I'm going to get Dave up there one of these days. So, yeah.
What about the rest of the guys, Leroy? Side projects? Hobbies?
I got a couple of musical things in mind that I'm going to try to get into this fall. But, you know, pretty much music is about the only thing I really can do.
Well, when you're good at something, you might as well stick to it, right? Yeah.
Bon, alors Cindy leur a demandé si mis à part le groupe, si les membres de la formation faisaient d'autres activités ou avaient d'autres projets à l'extérieur du groupe. Alors, Carter a répondu que, bon, évidemment, il jammait tout à l'extérieur du groupe, mais Carter aime beaucoup voler, alors il fait de l'avion. Et puis, c'est à peu près ça, oui. On passe tout de suite à la question Internet. You started the label ATO Records with the focus that take artists with talent and passion and take the time and attention to develop them. This is obviously not your regular corporate major record company type of thing. Did you feel that this was lacking in today's music industry?
Well, I got to give credit to a friend who worked with us for years, Michael McDonald, who was looking for something to do. And he's the president of that record company. And I think he just explains how I feel about music real well and how he acts with that record company. And yeah, it's just a kind of thing where, you know, it's sort of like a fantasy for him and a fantasy for me to be able to say, wow, I really like that. Let's put it out, you know, and find artists that are being overlooked. You know, David Gray was the example of, and you know, an artist that was dropped from his record company for a record that they thought was, you know, just not doing it. So and the next thing, it was number one all over the world, and it's gone platinum in the U.S. But just because it's so good, we were like, well, wow, this is a reason. Really, in some ways, David Gray was the reason we started ATM.
Matthews a parti sa propre étiquette de disques qui s'intitule ATO According to Our Records, c'est le nom de la compagnie de disques. Et puis il a parti surtout parce qu'il y a beaucoup d'artistes qui sont fort talentueux et qui n'ont pas la visibilité qui est nécessaire. Alors on lui a demandé s'il trouvait que la plupart des étiquettes de disques n'encourageaient pas le talent. Et puis c'était pour ça que lui, il avait fait ça. Et surtout à cause de David Gray, puisque vous savez que David Gray est le premier artiste.